What is up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. So it's that time again, MoGameCon 2022. At the time of this upload, it's roughly 2 weeks away from the convention. So as I've done in years past, I'm gonna be doing a vendor table preview, just kind of give people that are going to be going just a sampling of some of the cool and interesting things I'm gonna be selling. And for the people that can't make it, it just kind of give them an idea of what I'm gonna be selling, even though they can't be there. It's almost like they're virtually there. And maybe we can even make a deal before the convention starts if it's something that they can't attend. All right, guys, so let's not waste any more time. Let's get into it. All right, so I'm gonna try to go as fast as I can. Now, I got some Guitar Hero stuff. This stuff's making a comeback, I think. This is for PS3. I've got two Les Pauls here. Unfortunately, only one dongle, but one dongle is better than none. I've also got Guitar Hero 3 and Aerosmith for the PS3. This one is really cool. So this is Guitar Hero Warriors of Rock, complete in box, never been opened. For the Wii. Now the box has seen better days. It's got some tape on it, and it's kind of you know, a little banged up, but the guitar has never been pulled out. The game is still in there sealed. If you're wanting to get back into Guitar Hero, this is the one you're gonna want. And finally, in the Guitar Hero stuff, I've got my personal drum kit for Guitar Hero World Tour. This was for the Wii. Got the original drumsticks. All of these cables have been replaced. If you have one of these, you probably know that the cables for the cymbals and the drum pedal, they just dry rot and then they fall apart. All of those have been replaced. It's been tested. It works flawlessly. This thing is in impeccable condition, and it's just something we don't play anymore. We used to play as a family. You see here, I've got even the mic stand with the mic. All this is going. We used to actually, my two daughters would play guitar and I would play the drums and sing, and it was kind of like our own little Partridge Family, I guess.
The neighbors started booing me. Booing me! Do you know what that does for my ego?
All right, so one of the things in years past that I've been lacking at my table has been games. I've always had a lot of stuff. But the games, usually about 20 or so is all I have amongst all this other really cool stuff. So this year that's gonna change. I've got well over 150 loose and complete games, all really good quality titles. And these first ones are from my personal collection. I mentioned that in a previous video that I'm gonna be paring down my personal collection, and this is kind of a continuation of that process. So here we have some Saturn imports. Got King of the Fighters 95, King of the Fighters 96, Necronomicon Pinball, and Dungeons and Dragons Collection. These are all really good games. Next, we have Clockwork Knight 2, Duke Nukem 3D, and for PlayStation 1, a complete copy of Raiden Project. So these are also from my personal collection, Tony Hawk Skater 1 and 2 for the Switch, Doom for the Switch, Donkey Kong Country Tropical Freeze, and Astral Chain, another good bunch of titles here. Also got a complete copy of Doom 64, as well as Battle Tanks Global Assault. This is really neat. This is a game in the House of the Dead series called the Pinball of the Dead. You don't see this every day. It's getting kind of rare, so I expect this to sell pretty fast. All right, so like I mentioned, I have a bunch of loose games. These were mainly pickups from a garage sale. Got a bunch of great ones in here. Majora's Mask, Rayman 2, Mario Party 1 and 2, just lots and lots of good stuff. Most of these here were in a bundle deal that I got off Facebook that I was gonna do a video on and then I end up not doing. Just a bunch of great Super Nintendo titles. All right, here's some more Super Nintendo and Genesis games in the box. A lot of these were from my father-in-law. You see that Mega Man X mint copy right there, Lawnmower Man. And it doesn't end there. So this is a giant box.
The last time, I don't want your giant box of pornography.
No, no. It's just full of NES, Super NES, and Genesis games, and really, really quality stuff. I mean, Earthworm Jim 1 and 2, Vector Man. Here is an excellent copy of Hyperstone Heist. Just great, great titles here. Streets of Rage 1 and 2. Here we got Ninja Warriors, Final Fantasy 3, Legend of Zelda, Castlevania, Kirby's All-Stars. I think Contra's in here. Yeah, Contra. Next, we got Chippendale's Rescue Rangers. I mean, look at this. Darkwing Duck. DuckTales, Final Fantasy. I got Castlevania 1, 2, and 3. I mean, there are tons. There's over 60 games in this box. All excellent, excellent titles. So I got a few rare items here. This is a black box Duck Hunt that I got in a bundle back in January. Probably regret selling this. I don't think I'll ever find one in this condition again. So I will be entertaining offers on this one. Speaking of rare games, this is one of the rarest Game Boy games in existence. This is Spud's Adventure. This is for the Game Boy. Right now, the prices are kind of all over the place. It's usually in the $400 to $500 range. Loose, which is insane for a game that's really not that great. But, you know, it is just something that you don't see every day. This was a very low print run. And if you're looking for it, I may be the only person there that has this. All right, so if you're a big Zelda fan, you're gonna want this. This is a 1989 Zelda Nelsonic digital watch. Really cool, it's working, and don't think I'll have any problem selling this. Prices are kind of all over the place on this as well, but I will have this price to sell.
I have $2, and a Casio.
All right, so I always like to load up on Pokemon before a convention, anything Pokemon, and this year I've got quite a few stuff. So I've got two copies of Ruby for the Game Boy Advance. I've got a copy of Leaf Green. Here are some loose 3DS Pokemon titles. Got a version of Pokemon Black version 2 for the DS, and then Pokemon Ultra Sun. And this one here, I honestly don't know. This was in a bundle deal. It's I think this is a Pokemon Ranger Japanese version, and this is the copy that it came with, and then this was in the box as well. It's like a different version of that. I honestly don't know anything about it. There is a label variation here, so it's not the same game, but it might be like two versions of Pokemon Ranger. I don't know. This won't be priced that high, obviously, because it's a game that you can't be able to read. So this is something that's really for just the person that really wants everything Pokemon. All right, so I've always sold t-shirts at the convention in the past, and they've always sold out. And this year I've got some more. These are brand new, sealed. I got two Ninja Turtles. These are Funko Pop t-shirts. And this is a Stranger Things one. Really cool packages too. These should sell pretty fast. So a couple of cool random items here. This is this Panasonic boombox that I picked up on Facebook. I'm gonna be letting go of this. This thing, it's not the biggest and the rarest by any means, but man, does it sound amazing. And the reception is phenomenal for something this old. And this is pretty cool too. This is a Risk Metal Gear Solid Edition. Everything's there except the rule book. The original rule book was gone, but I do have a PDF file printed out for this. So other than that, it's just like it was, and the condition is just really, really good. Now, last but not least, we have consoles and handhelds. Here I've got a 2DS. Anybody interested in that? Here is a Monster Hunter new 3DS XL, and then a regular black 3DS XL. This thing is loaded with games. The person I bought it from did not care about the account anymore. There are a ton of games on here. Shantae's on here. It's just loaded with games. Here is an AGS 101 Game Boy Advance SP with a Legend of Zelda shell. This thing is bad to the bone. And I've got some Nintendo Switches. This is the Indigo Switch Lite with a Satisfy grip and a 128 gigabyte card. I think that's what's in there. This thing is literally like it's been out of the package and never used. It's incredibly mint. So if you're looking for a Switch Lite, come and find me. This thing is awesome and it's ready to go with this case. I have the charger as well. It's all there. And check this out. I've got a Switch OLED, brand new. Never been opened. Still can't believe what I paid for this. It's insane the deals that you can find. Again, I will have this price way lower than retail. If you've been putting off buying a Switch OLED, this is the one you're gonna want. You're gonna save quite a bit off of retail. Okay, and now the big dogs. This is part of that other NES bundle that came with Duck Hunt. I profiled these in a video. I opened them blind, didn't even know what was actually inside of these boxes. The cool thing is, I mean, these are in excellent, excellent condition. You're not gonna find too many boxes in this condition. I've also got the box protectors. But I did add the correct Mario Brothers that would go with this, the five screw Super Mario Brothers. And I did, it's got the sleeve and the manual. Do not have the box, unfortunately, but that's pretty hard to find. And I also retrobrighted this console, so it looks 10 times better than it did when I originally opened it up. So if you are wanting a really good showpiece quality Nintendo Control Deck complete, this is the one you're gonna want. You know, it's just, it's ready to go for you. And the last two here, I've got a TurboGrafx 16 Mini. This one, this is a recent pickup. This is another one that I was like, do I really keep this? Do I sell it? I think I'm gonna sell it. I don't have any nostalgia for this thing. And I looked over the games list. Yeah, there's some good ones on there, but I just don't see myself playing this. I see this just sitting on a shelf. So for that reason, I am going to probably part with this. And this last item, again, I can't believe I'm parting with, but this is not my original Saturn. This is also a recent pickup. And the guy gave me a great deal on it. This is another collector grade. Every single item, all the baggies, warranty card, poster, the console itself was in the plastic. It's really barely been played. And it's not a super rare box variant, but man, the condition of this thing. This is one that I would like to get rid of, only because, I mean, I've already got a Saturn and it's a Japanese version, it's modded. I have no need for this other than to put it on a shelf, and it's, what good is that doing? So this is going to get sold, but I'm not going to just give it away, because you're just not gonna come across this too often. I mean, I will be cheaper than anybody else at the convention on any of my stuff, but this one, I'll try to work with somebody as best I can, but the reality is that this is a mint. Probably you could almost grade this thing Sega Saturn. This will be there, plus a whole lot more. All right, guys, so there you have it. That is just a small portion of some of the things I'm gonna be selling, and it's gonna be a great, great time. I'm really looking forward this year to meeting some people that I haven't met before, but I've known through YouTube, people like 8BitGlitch79. I think Megadan's gonna be there as well. And then to see people that I have met before but haven't seen in a while. Do You Nerd is always fun to hang out with. Cool Toy is going to be there. I haven't seen him since I think year four. Gary Katzer from Rock Solid Productions, it'd be nice to see him. And also Gaming Off the Grid will be right next to me this year as well, just like it was last year, as well as my buddy Jared. Last year we had so much fun that we managed to get together again, so they're going to be my partners in crime, my booth buddies, whatever you want to call it, and I cannot wait. It's going to be a blast. And we're also going to be going to Two Plumbers the night before, which is a barcade in St. Charles, Missouri. So if you're in the area and you want to hang out with people like Gaming Off the Grid or Do You Nerd, go to Two Plumbers on Friday evening, and we'll have a beer together. And I've said this before too, if you come up to the booth and you've ever seen one of my videos, just please say hi. Don't be a stranger. I would love to chat with you. It really makes me feel good to talk to people that enjoy my videos. And even if you don't enjoy the videos, I don't care. Just, it's the reason why I like to sell is not just to make money. I really do enjoy the interaction and people coming up and them looking at your things and starting a conversation about, like, where did you get that? And I remember when I had that, things like that. So, you know, this is fun. I feel like I've kind of found my niche here. I really like being someone who's selling things as opposed to buying them. I know that's not for everybody. It makes some people uncomfortable, but for me, it really is something that gives me joy, honestly, you know, bottom of my heart. You know, I just see myself doing it as long as this convention is going on, and I really hope that in the future this thing can get to the size of some of these other conventions. I know it doesn't happen overnight to be a Too Many Games or a PRG, but, you know, hopefully this can grow, and eventually it'll be like maybe a multi-day event. I know that they've kind of shied away from that. They used to do it, I think, the first year. But I think that if you have the people, if you have the space, if you have the vendors, all those things will eventually kind of follow.
If you build it, Nerds will come.
And hopefully that's where this is heading. I would love to see this thing just blow up and be like top five. It's never going to be, you know, a Midwest classic, but it would be nice to be regarded as one of the ones to go to. And I'm just so glad to be a part of it. The organizers are amazing. So if you guys can make it, make sure to come out to the St. Charles Community College on July 30th. And tickets are very cheap. You know, it's going to be a great time. All the vendor tables are sold out. So hope to see you there. All right, you know the drill. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to hit that thumbs up. And if you're new to the channel, please consider subscribing. It really helps out. All right, guys, I will see you all next time. Thanks so much for watching.